Hi guys, welcome to my channel Curiosity Burnt My Kitchen. I am Mihir Darji and today we are going to be making spinach ricotta ravioli. I'm going to be making the pasta from scratch. I have made the ricotta from scratch, just that I've not grown the spinach from scratch. So let's get started. So we are going to start off with our pasta dough. For our pasta dough, we are going to require 1 cup of refined flour, which is your maida. We are going to require 1 cup of semolina, which is rava. And you have to ensure that your semolina or rava is fine. You also get jada rava in the market, but if it is that, then just make sure that you pulse it in the mixer and make it fine. You'll need half a cup of warm water. Please ensure that your water is warm, and salt. So now I'm just going to add all of it in the mixing bowl. First I'm going for rava, then the maida, and about half a teaspoon or a teaspoon of salt. Giving it a mix before I add in my water so that the salt is incorporated well. Now adding in my half cup of warm water. At this point I'm going to get my hands dirty. Keep some more warm water with you because you may need to add a little to make your dough. I'm just going to add a little. And please put very little at a time or your dough is going to be wet and then you're going to add more flour. So we have to knead this dough for about 10 minutes. यार जिम नहीं खुले अब तक यार थोड़ा वर्कआउट कर लो. सो आई एम डन विथ माई डो. यू कैन सी इट्स अ नाइस फॉर्म डो. आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू टक इट इनटू अ बॉल एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कवर दिस इन प्लास्टिक रैप और क्लिंग रैप एंड वी आर गोइंग टू लेट इट सिट फॉर अबाउट 20 मिनट्स. सो आवर डो इज नाइसली रैप्ड इन क्लिंग रैप एंड आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू लेट इट सिट इन अ वार्म प्लेस फॉर अबाउट 20 मिनट्स. नाउ व्हाइल आवर डो रेस्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट प्रिपेयरिंग अ फिलिंग. फॉर योर फिलिंग यू आर गोइंग टू रिक्वायर अबाउट 200 ग्राम्स ऑफ स्पिनच एंड आई हैव रफली चॉप्ड द स्पिनच. And here I have about 1 cup of ricotta. So to start with the filling, we are going to blanch our spinach first. To blanch your spinach, you will need a pot of water and get the water to a boil. I have just added a pinch of salt. And now I'm going to put in my spinach into the boiling water. So while your spinach is in the hot water, you will prepare your ice bath, which is just a bowl of water and you will add ice in it. So now that my spinach has been in the boiling water for about 2 minutes, I'm just going to take this and I'm just going to transfer it to the ice bath. The ice bath will prevent your spinach from cooking further and it will also retain that nice and green color. So now while our spinach is sitting in our ice bath, we are going to start preparing with our ricotta. So I'm just going to take ricotta and I'm just going to put it into a bowl. I'm just going to take a fork and roughly mash it, adding in a pinch of salt. So I have this dried basil powder which I use for a lot of my seasonings. You can use a herb of your preference. I just like the taste of this, so I'm just going to add this to my ricotta and spinach stuffing. So now that our spinach has been resting in the ice bath, we are going to remove it from the ice bath and I'm going to put it on a paper towel to ensure that all the moisture, excess moisture that we do not require, has been soaked up. So after my spinach had been dried out and the excess moisture was out, I've added my spinach to the ricotta and now I'm just going to mix it all together. I'm going to use my hands. So you can also use a strainer to drain out all the excess moisture from your spinach. I would have ideally roasted a bit of garlic and added to my filling, but since I've got a lot of requests for a Pure Gen recipe, so I've tried to make this a Pure Gen recipe. I hope you guys appreciate it. So now my stuffing is ready. Our dough had been resting for 20 minutes, so now it's ready to be rolled out. So let's get started. Now that our dough is here, I'm just going to knead it for 30 seconds more. I'm going to take a scraper and work with quarter of the dough at a time. I'm just going to cut them into quarters and I'm going to work with one quarter at a time. I'm just going to roll it into a ball. Sprinkle some flour on my bench. And now we start rolling our dough out into a thin flat surface. After it is rolled out a little, you will fold it into thirds. Turn it over and then start the process again. We will repeat this process for a couple of times. Again, fold it into thirds. Roll it over. Start again. Now I'm just going to roll it into a thin surface. So now my sheet has been rolled out. You can see it has to be thin where you can slightly see the color of your finger through it. That is how thin you have to roll it out. So now I'm going to show you two ways how to make your ravioli. First, I have this small bowl, or you can use any round cutter that you have. So I'm just going to use this tiny bowl and make as many circles as I can from the dough. So I've got 6 circles out of my dough. And if you have any excess dough, don't worry about it. You can always turn them into your favorite shape of pasta, and you can store it in your freezer for about 3 to 4 weeks. So now I'm going to take my filling and I'm just going to add a little in the center. Make sure you don't overfill it. It's your ravioli will be very thick and it won't seal off completely. Now we're just going to take the other circles that we've rolled and place it on top. Start pressing from close to your filling and then you move towards the edges. You have to ensure there are no air bubbles inside. Now this still looks like a boring ravioli since I didn't have one of those fancy cutters where it creates a nice pattern on the edges. So I'm going to show you a quick hack how you can make those patterns at home. All you need is a fork. And now I'm just going to gently press the forks on the edges all around. You just press it on the sides and get a nice pattern so that they're nice to look at and people will be impressed with your cooking skills. You see how they have these nice edges now and they're fun to look at. So now I'm going to show you the second method for making a ravioli. So you will have your rolled out dough here and all you need is a knife, and I'm just going to cut off like so. Now that it is cut off, I'm going to take my filling again. I'm going to add it with a distance of about 1 inch between each so that I can cut my ravioli off later. Now I'm just going to place the other sheet on top of it. Once again, start pressing close to your stuffing and move to the edges. Don't worry about the uneven edges. So now I'm just going to cut them off. You ensure that when you're cutting off your sheets, they're of equal length and they're of equal size. But it's all right because now I'm going to use a fork to, you know, give it a pattern again. So as you can see, after I've used a fork to give it a pattern, the edges are not really prominent. They are still visible, but I don't think anyone's going to notice it. So our raviolis are ready. These are the ones that I cut and I made it. And I have the ones that we used a tiny bowl to make these. So now we are going to prepare our sauce and we are going to put our ravioli for cooking. So please remember, since this is fresh pasta, it will only take about 2 to 3 minutes in boiling water. It is not going to take as much time as store-bought pasta. So now, as you can see, the water has come up to a boil and I've added a pinch of salt to the water and I'm going to add in my ravioli in the water. So once your ravioli starts floating, you will know that it's done. So while the ravioli is cooking, I'm going to start preparing my sauce. So I've taken a pan and it's on medium heat and I'm going to add in my butter. To this butter, I'm going to add just a little bit of olive oil. This is just to avoid that your butter doesn't burn out. So now that my butter is melted, I'm going to add in my basil. I've chopped them roughly. Make sure your pan is not too hot. And so I spoke about lemon zest. So you'll take a grater, any grater, as fine as possible. You need the rind, basically the outer part of your lemon. So you're just going to start from the top and move to the bottom. And make sure you do not go all the way in where you can see the white parts. Don't go further than this because then you'll get the bitter taste. So I've added in about the zest of about 1 lemon. And now, as you can see, the butter is turning slightly brown. And my sauce is almost done. So the raviolis have started floating and they're almost done. They are done here, as you can see. As I said, they're fresh pasta, so they're only going to take about 2 to 3 minutes to cook. So now I'm just going to remove it from the pan and keep it aside on a plate. To this butter, I'm going to add just a little 2 spoons of my pasta water. I don't know about you guys, but I can already smell the basil and the lemon and it's delicious. So now my butter is almost there. I'm getting a nice brown color to it. I do not want it to be overburnt. So at this point, I'm just going to add in my raviolis. Ensure that every bit of your ravioli has the sauce on it. This is a very simple recipe and a very simple dish. Even though your sauce doesn't have too many ingredients, it's going to taste really amazing, trust me. So now I'm done, I'm just going to take it off a gas and put it on a serving bowl.
So here, you can see the ravioli is done. It looks so good. Oh my god, I can't wait to go into the taste test and get my reviews. So today for my taste test, I have my neighbor Rahul.
Looks very tempting.
I hope it tastes good.
It is very nice. The flavor of basil, cheese is very distinct and coming very proper.
Do you get the lemon zest in your sauce?
It is there. The lemon zest is also, you can feel the flavor. It's not too sort of strong, so it's subtle, so you can feel it very well.
You get a nice tang.
Yeah, it's nice.
I hope you guys like the recipe. If you want the recipe for ricotta, please let me know in the comments below. And if you have any suggestions, please put them in the comment section below and I'll try to make it. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. If you do end up making the recipes, then please tag me on Instagram. My handle name is CuriosityBurnt My Kitchen.